Hello. Let's take some look at some flash brackets. Or you can use them for whatever. Cold shoe, extending mount, or yeah, call it whatever you want. But it's an extending arm you can extend and use for, yeah, you know, flashes, LED lights, video lights, microphones and other stuff like that. I find this very useful. In fact, I use one right now in my camera up here for my video light at the top and the microphone here at the side. And of course the camera here in the middle. It's very useful for mounting several devices on your camera, video camera, or yeah. I think it's most usable for video cameras, I don't know. Maybe it would be nice to mount a flash some way, a tiny way from the body. I don't know what should be the benefit of this. But anyway, let's try and open this boxes and see what's inside and test them out with some accessories. Of course, yeah, you can see the box here. Flash bracket, of course, made in China. Nothing really stands out to this box, just a white box. I'll try and open it. Let's see what's inside. Let's put the box over here. This one, you can see here, it has a handle. It's very nice for you can put your camera here and you have some great handle for video. Great for stabilizing the shot. And you can see at the top here, you got two cold shoe mounts, one at the top and one on the side here. So you could have your video light here maybe and your microphone here. And at the bottom, just a standard, a quarter inch screw to mount on your camera, and another one quarter inch at the bottom of this screw or tightening up, so you can mount this to a tripod or whatever you want to use this for. I have my Fuji X-T1 here, which is my main shooting photo camera at the moment. I haven't upgraded to the X-T2 yet, but I found this to be more than enough for my needs. Let's try and mount this on the bottom here. Let me think, yes, it should be this way. And you should see, you can see this here. Like this. And you can, you know, make it fit, you know, slide back and forth. You can see here, maybe it would be best like this, so there's a little room for my hand as well. And does stand on there very tightly. Ah, of course, I put it on the wrong way. Let's just put it on the other way around like this. This is the way it's meant to be, on the left side of the camera. You can see here, you can hold the camera in this handle alone, or you can, you know, support it like this, which is very nice, you know, for video, doing some pan shooting. Yes, let's try to mount some stuff. If it would me, I would probably mount the microphone here on the left one, so that I could get the light as close to center as possible. I don't have any spare LED light at the moment, so I found my hot shoe flash that the Fuji X-T1 came with. Let's try this out. The EF/X8 Fujifilm, but of course it wouldn't work because it needs the connection for the flash at the bottom here. You can see the connection that is on this hot shoe. This one here is a cold shoe, and this one on the camera is a hot shoe because it's actively. And this is not active. There's no connections here. But anyway, we can put it like this. If it even would fit, maybe because of this. Yes, like this. So if, just if you can imagine, this is a bigger flash and or maybe some video light. You can see this is a pretty nice setup. You can quickly mount, you know, microphone and flash or LED light to this this camera. Of course, the X-T1 is not a video camera at all. This is a stills camera. So it would mainly be used for flash. And maybe you can use some video or some light doing macro shooting, I don't know. But anyway, of course you have the thread in the bottom as well. So you could put it on a tripod here. Just have a Manfrotto. What's this? 498 RC2. Tripod head. And of course you could quite easily, if I could just, no, it's not for one hand, let me just like this, take off the mounting plate, and you could tighten this to the bottom as well, and you can put this on a tripod. Like so. And of course you could just click it in the tripod here. And you're good to go. If you want to do some overhead shots or whatever. So yeah, I like this bracket. It's pretty inexpensive. But again, it gives you some benefits. Of course, these are cold shoes, like I said. So you won't have any data connection. But for microphones and video lights and, you know, if you wanted to move the flash just a little away from the body, this would be a good mount. Now let's try to take it off again. Let's have a look at this other one. Oh, nice, of course, like this. Let's see if we can get this plate off as well. One downside is, you know, there's only one screw here. So there's a lot of, what can you say? I don't know how well it would hold on the camera if you mount, you know, heavy flashes here. Maybe it will move slightly because there's only one tightening spot at the bottom. But, you know, you could just be a little careful. But if you put this on a tripod and you put the tripod here and this screw up to the camera, there's not much holding it in place. Only this one screw for everything. Anyway, let's try the next one. Let's just get off all the stuff here. Let's take the microphone off and the flash off. So this was the first, I guess you could call it a L bracket because it has a L to it. Now let's have a look at the second one. This is let's just have a look at the box first. You can see here, C-shaped bracket, because it's the shape of a C. Nice. And you can see perfect miniature camcorder. C-shaped brackets, user-friendly design, and so on. It's very user-friendly. Now let's try to take it out. See what's inside. Another bracket in a plastic bag. Surprise, surprise. Put the box over here. And yeah, you can see this one has a shape of a C. So it's named a C bracket. Yes, and you can, this one you can move in several positions. And tighten it to the camera here. So, only this one only has one hot shoe, cold shoe, but you could easily connect several others to this mount. It shouldn't be that hard. Okay, let's try to mount it to the camera. I don't know which way is best. Maybe this is the other way. If it's supposed to be on the picture, it's like this way. Let's try this one. It doesn't really matter, you know, this one is not a handle, this is just a C bracket. So whatever way you need is, this is the way you should mount it. And of course there's a tightening screw right here as well, so you can tighten this up. And you could just maybe move this around a little bit. So put it like here. And put in a microphone. This will be a good way to move the microphone from the body if you're experiencing some noise from the focusing system or whatever. You know, some low level noise on the microphone. You could just move it slightly away from the body, and this should eliminate at least some of the low frequency noise. So I think this is pretty nice, and it also has some rubberized handle here for quick holding. But the nice thing about this one is it also, let's try this out here, it also can be mounted like this. I don't know if you can see here, let's tighten this up here. Because of the C shape, of course I have the external or extra grip on mine, so the mount is further down than it would be normally. It would be up here, so you know, you can see it's very close to the lens right here, the C mount. But this way you could get the microphone closer to the subject but still away from the body. I think this is a really nice feature. You can see here. So it's like extends the camera or the mount just to the front here, and on the side here you can tilt the C bracket so it goes around the lens. Great for like this microphones, or if you would like to, you know, put your flash here or LED light here, you could put things closer to the subject. Plus you can have several things here if you have more of these cold shoe brackets. These cost like nothing on eBay, so shouldn't be hard to get. So I really like this bracket. Actually, this is what I'm using right now. I have a setup like this. I'm a camera up here. I don't know if I can make me create some reflections in this. You can see, but my LED light up there, my microphone to the right, and the camera in the middle. So you can see I have my LED light. I have it set all the way up here to light as, you know, straight down as possible. And at the microphone, I have mounted it like this. Oh, let me see if I can just loosen this a little bit. I've mounted it like this. The camera is set like this and the microphone is like this. So it will be closer to my mouth when I'm doing this overhead shot. I think this is a brilliant bracket. Actually, I bought several of these brackets just to have some to play around with. The one downside is, again, only one screw here. So I don't know how stable it will be. You know, there is some movement. I guess you could tighten it even more, but then again, there is some slight movement here. But I think it would hold steady, even with some bigger lights and microphones. What I have done with mine, I've drilled a little hole here in the C bracket, right up here. And I have made a little dent or indentation right here at the lower part, and I have put a screw through so that when it's in this position, it cannot move. Basically, I put a screw inside or through it. So that's, I think it's, now the microphone flew away. That's the perfect setup for me right now. Because, like I said, I use my camera like this, like overhead shots. I have the microphone here, close to my mouth, and I have the LED light right up here, shining down to the subject. Plus, I can mount the camera here on the lower part of the bracket. This part here, And in my case, my battery door on my Panasonic camera that I'm filming with now is on the bottom. And the tripod mount is actually right around here. So I don't have much room to play with. But with this setup, I have enough room to open the door. And when I have connected my tripod here, there's nothing really in the way to get into the SD card or battery without any issues. Plus, all my lighting and microphones are exactly where I want them to be. And this bracket, it costs like nothing, I can't even remember. I can put the links in the description to eBay where I bought these. Great brackets, I think. You can modify them just slightly, you know, put a screw in, drill a hole and screw a screw together to make these two pieces more stable. This way you can make it dead steady, and you can use this actually as a handle if you had any benefit in that. Yeah. Two great cheap brackets that can upgrade your system pretty fast and easy. And cheaply as well. I hope you find this useful. Thank you for watching. And bye bye. Hello again. Just wanted to show you one more bracket you can mount to your... This one is for the hot shoe. It's a very nice accessory. You can put three cold shoe to one hot shoe on your camera. I forgot this in the first take. But yeah, let's open it up and let's see what's inside. You can see a triple shoe V bracket, Easy Hood, and the model number down here, EVB 105, and it's from machined aluminium. You can see here on the back, you can have, for example, your microphone in one and the LED light in the other. And you can see the website here, easyhood.net. Easy Hood. It's so easy. Yeah, let's try to open it and see the Easy Hood. Here it is. And there's some, it's just a cardboard with, you know, the same information as I just showed you. Let's put the packaging over here. You can see this Easy Hood. It's a very small hood, bracket, whatever you want to call it. You can see some branding on the side here. Of course, metal cold shoe here with a metal tightening ring lock thingy. Of course, this goes to the top of the hot shoe on the camera. You can see here my X-T1. Fujifilm. Let's just try to put this protective cover off and let's mount the bracket here. You know, you can put it both ways, both this and this, whatever you find more useful. And let's try this one as first. Put it down here, like this. And of course you tighten the screw here, so it won't go anywhere, at least not easily. Ah, in fact, I think this one is meant to go the other way. You can see the little stopper here for the cold shoe. But you can use it both ways, but let's just put it the other way around. I like to keep the shoe in this direction so I can put him down here and it will stop him from sliding further. Yeah. One of the reasons I don't use this myself is because, you know, I have a big LED light here, microphone here. You know, you put a lot of strain to this one little hot shoe on your camera. You know, if you damage this, then, you know, the camera has to go to repair. So I like to use brackets more like this, you know, I showed you before, where you can tighten it to the camera body, to the screw hole in the camera, and of course that could break as well, but and then mount it on the tripod will take all the force, and only the camera would have to carry it itself on the bracket, at least that's for my liking. But this is a good little solution as well. You can of course put your flash here. And let's try the microphone here. And you can see, you're good to go. That's just for a minute, pretend that it's actually a LED light I have here, but I haven't gotten any to try out right now. But yeah, but again, it put a lot of strain to this hot shoe right here in the camera, which is not something I'm a big fan of. I mean, it's probably made for it, you know, to take some beating, but I would rather, you know, have my tripod hold whatever. But this is, if you're hand holding, this is superb. Another thing I want to show you is the other bracket I showed you before, this one with the handle on the left side. You can see here, it's good for mounting to a smartphone as well. You can put the microphone in here, or video lighting. You can see I mounted just the smartphone bracket here, and you can put in any smartphone and use it as a, you know, a device to control your smartphone photography. So I think this is great for that as well. Anyway, I hope you find this useful. There's several different kind of brackets to use. The one I use now for my main camera up here, you can see up here, it's the C bracket. I find that most useful for my main setup. But this one, I will use this for my smartphone. And then and this Y bracket is nice if you are going handheld. You know, you can put your light, a microphone, and even a third thing down here, whatever that should be. And of course, you can mount this to a tripod stand as well, like this. So if you need some cold shoes for some flashes and lights, you can put them on a tripod anywhere, or a microphone for that matter. You don't even have to put this on your camera. So yeah. Anyhow, thank you for watching. Take care. Bye bye.